Hi guys, welcome back. So far we have seen how to play along with a single instance of MongoDB, and then we have also seen how to gather up the instances and create a replica set and play along with the replica set configurations and the election process. So now what we would be doing is jumping into the sharding architecture, or seeing how to create sharded clusters in your MongoDB environment. In this particular section, we'll have a look at the components of sharded cluster. And the agenda would be having a look at what exactly are shards, what is a shard key and what is the importance of it, what are config servers and what is the importance of Mongo as server. So let's first try to build a scenario around this to understand the mechanism properly. So let's say I have an employee database which is having records from employee ID 1 to employee ID 100. Then let's say I have two replica sets. This I group up and call as shard 1. Then I have another replica set, which I group up and call as shard 2. Then I have another single MongoDB instance, which I call as shard 3. Then let's say I have another server called as Mongo S, which would be the single point of contact for all my application servers, which would be sitting here. Then let's say there is something called as the config servers, which would be assisting your Mongo S for the listings in the shard servers. Now, what do I mean by this? Let's say shard 1 has data from employee ID 1 to employee ID 25. Shard 2 has data from employee ID 26 to employee ID 75. And shard 3 has data from employee ID 76 to employee ID 100. Now this information is something which would be maintained into the config servers. And whenever any read or write operation is happening, that would be directed first to the Mongo S, which will take the location access of the data from the config servers. And based on that, it will internally redirect the application server's request to either shard 1, either shard 2, or any of the available shard based on where the data is located. Now, there are a couple of more concepts like the balancer and splitter, which are involved into the sharding clusters and architecture, which will make sure that at any given point of time, all the shards are equally utilized. And because of this, in case you add a new shard to your cluster, you don't have to worry about the migration process. The balancers and splitters will easily identify it as a newly added shard, and moreover, will identify it as an underutilized shard, and then it will complete the migration process automatically so that all the current shards are equally utilized. And this is the reason why it is said that MongoDB sharding provides something called as automatic scaling. Now, if you try to visualize the comparison between a replication and sharding, then I can say that whenever your operations are read intensive, you can have replica set at your rescue. And whenever your operations are write intensive as well, then you can have sharding clusters at your rescue. And together, you will have a very powerful read and write scalable mechanism of MongoDB available. So this is what your sharding is.